Hi, and welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and with me is Martin Kutzer, who is the certification exam planner for this very exam, which we're talking about, 7341 Core Solutions of Microsoft Exchange Server 2013. It's the first exam in your MCSE messaging. So now, Martin, you work for us today, but you spent 10 plus years in the field with folks.
Yes, Jay. I recently joined Microsoft Learning, but came back from South Africa as a consultant, where I deployed Exchange for lots of customers over the years. And now I'm in Redmond working on exams.
So, Martin, 25% of this exam is on transport, but didn't we kill the hub transport server? What's the deal with that?
Well, Jay, messaging is about transport. So we still need to send messages around. So transport is still a really important part of the Exchange architecture. And we need to make sure that those components that is configurable on the mailbox server now and on the CAS server is available to people and is one of the things that they can set up in terms of anti-spam, set up in terms of the language settings that you can configure, set up in terms of the things that you want to block. So transport is something really important that people need to know still.
Okay. You know, we've also been saying, Microsoft has for years, that people shouldn't be using public folders. Can you explain a little bit to the folks what the deal is with public folders these days and why we're testing on it?
Well, Jay, public folders is one of those things that people really love to hate.
Okay.
And for the first time since so many versions, have we made changes in public folders in Exchange 2013. Public folders is now part of the mailbox database. So the architecture has changed significantly in Exchange 2013. It's still supported, but now a public folder is just a mailbox inside of a mailbox database, okay, which allows you to replicate that database, and this improves the high availability story for public folders. We can now fail over public folder databases to other servers and so on. Obviously, this new architecture means that you need to think about migration. How do you migrate your existing public folders to the new public folder architecture, and how do you coexist, and if that is in all possible? So it's a really important topic for people to do.
You know, another important topic, you mentioned CAS earlier, and it seems like the CAS server has changed a lot. Can you tell us what has changed?
CAS server has changed a lot. CAS server now is responsible for authentication and proxy. So people connect to the CAS server, and the CAS server will then authenticate that user and then make sure that it proxies to the correct mailbox server. So there's not a lot of rendering and logic running on the CAS server except for making those two decisions. Are you allowed to connect? So we authenticate you, and do we need to proxy or redirect you to a different site? The concepts of proxy and redirect works fairly the same way as it worked in 2010. There's a few differences that allow site resiliency now. So if the redirection is to a name that's the same as the current site, that CAS server will then just proxy the request.
Okay.
So there's a couple of differences between the previous version, but it's still a really important topic, and it's something that is re-architected completely.
Okay. Another acronym that people have trouble with is RBAC. Now, I have no idea what RBAC stands for. Can you explain to me and tell them why we test on it?
Yes, so rollback access control is one of those features that a lot of people try to avoid. It's one of those features that is difficult to implement if you don't know how to do it. So my recommendation to the people taking this test is to play with it. Go and download a step-by-step guide, or go and find a walkthrough from somebody that's written a blog on this topic, and do this for yourself and see how you can delegate access to people in your organization so that they can only do what they're supposed to do. When it comes to RBAC, you have to think about the triangle of power.
Okay, what's that?
The triangle of power is the three things that you need to configure when you set up RBAC, and that is who can do this, where can they do this, and what can they do. So when you configure those three things, you've set up an RBAC role.
Okay.
So everything that you need to do, you need to address those three things, and then you know RBAC.
And that's a technology that Microsoft is implementing in other server products like SharePoint and whatnot.
Yes, RBAC is the model that is now used in Link, SharePoint, and this allows people to think about how do you set up permissions, which is a lot easier than previously looking at ACLing or access control list to allow people to get access to various objects in the Active Directory.
Okay, so the last thing I want to talk about is PowerShell. A lot of people have come to me personally at TechEd and said, why do you guys test us on PowerShell? It's something I start to type in, it pops up the rest of the string. Why do I need to know that?
Well, Jay, PowerShell is really important in Exchange, and it's a decision that they made back in Exchange 2007 that this is the way you're going to manage Exchange.
Okay.
So, and you still have to know the differences between the various commands. Even though the commands autocomplete, some of them, like new-mailbox database, or new-mailbox, it's two completely different things, and you have to know the difference between the two. When are you going to create a new database? When are you going to create a new mailbox? And just by knowing that it will autocomplete, yes, it makes it easier for people, but you still have to know the difference between those commands, and you have to know which parameters is applicable in certain cases as well. So after working with Exchange for a while, like I've done, you really sort of embrace PowerShell and move away from the Exchange admin center and use a lot more PowerShell. So I think it's really powerful to use PowerShell and use it as a way to make sure that all your components and everything is logged. You have a change log of what you did. And so PowerShell is something that we think that Exchange administrators must know.
Okay. Well, thanks so much for being here, Martin. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
So we've been talking about 7341, which is Core Solutions for Microsoft Exchange Server 2013. It's the first of your messaging MCSE exams. So build a lab, download some guides, and go take that test.